like, it's still feel like it's 100 degrees out here, y'all. And we are at the end of September. I miss my cool weather. I miss my sweaters. I miss my Uggs. Did I mention I hate it here? Let me tell y'all what happened yesterday. On my lunch break, I like to go run in the shower. I don't know. I have this thing, like, I want to shower before, like, I get off. So I usually go and take a shower on lunch. So I'm in there, you know, got my clothes off and everything. Got one leg in the shower, right? One leg in the shower. And I don't know, I was getting ready to bring my other leg, my right leg around, and closing the shower curtain at the same time, and I seen it. It was an outline, but I seen it. Y'all, when I tell you, even then, I didn't realize how big it was until I got out. It was the biggest water bug I've ever seen in my life. When I tell y'all, this thing was huge. It was huge. It was like, I want to say like it was the size of my hand. No lie. Or at least like to where my fingers in. That's how huge this freaking water bug was. I jumped out, did a damn split on the bathroom floor, ran out, closed the bathroom door so that it couldn't get out, and I'm panicking, I'm home by myself, I left the shower on, the shower is running, so I'm like, oh my God, what do I do? I'm like itching and about ready to cry. Okay, so I called my husband at work. He's at work. My son was at work. I was like, oh, it's big. I don't know what to do. And he's like, well, I can't really come on. Bugs. See, trying to sit outside to get me some vitamin D, and it's just not working. Is it vitamin D? Just trying to catch some sun, y'all, some rays. I can't. So I called my husband at work. He's like, well, see if one of the guys from downstairs is outside. So I'm like, half of my body's wet from the water dripping down. So I put on my clothes real quick and I go to the porch, and sure enough, one of the guys that I guess his friend lives downstairs on the first floor, he actually lives around the other way. He was outside. I was like, could you please come up? Can you please come up and kill this water bug? Like, he's like, where is it? He started calling, coming upstairs. I said, it's in my bathroom. Y'all, when he opened the door, and I'm like, damn it is, the shit looked like it doubled in size. So he is like, I don't know if it flew or what the hell. Then it was like trapped in a damn corner. Y'all, then it started like trying to come out the bathroom. I jumped on the bed. My knee is still hurting from the way I jumped on the bed. He ended up getting it. And he's like talking to it like it's nothing. He's like, yeah, shaking like a stripper. Yeah, I was like, y'all, that was the biggest freaking bug I've seen in my life. And I don't know why it was in my bathroom. Like, I don't know. I've seen a water bug a couple of times here, and it always seems like it's in my bathroom. Mind you, we have two bathrooms. Never see them in my son's bathroom or anywhere else, just my bathroom. And I said, we're gonna have to figure this shit out. We're gonna have to figure this out. Otherwise, I'm not taking. What kind of freaking bug is that? Like about three bugs attached to each other. I thought the bug fell. It's an acorn that fell from the tree on the yard. I gotta go. I can't. I thought I would come up here and talk to y'all, get some sun or whatever, but it's just not working. It's not working. Like, this is like part of the main reason why I freaking hate Texas. Like, I cannot wait to get out of here. I have to get out of here. The biggest reason, well, I haven't seen any yet, so I'm not even gonna mention it. I'm not gonna mention them. Do ever see one? Your girl will not be here any longer. I'm going back. I'm going back. It's just taking a little time, but if I ever run across, and I'm not gonna say the word, nope, you're gone. Your girl will be gone. I will go back home and stay with a friend and let them come later and figure it out. I ain't playing those games. But y'all, the water bug was so huge. Like, if I had actually closed the shower and started washing, I wouldn't be sitting here right now. I would not be sitting here right now. That's how damn big it was. I don't know, y'all. But anyway, I wanted to come say hi. Happy Saturday. What are y'all doing today? Me, I'm not doing much. Just chilling. Just like a chill day for me. Well, actually, I'm working on some personal stuff. I recently started therapy. I'm not sure. I know I mentioned it before, but I recently started therapy and my therapist gave me some homework. So what I'm supposed to do this weekend is to write down where I see myself in a year. Like everything that I want to accomplish, or I guess where I see myself in a year. And I never thought that this could be so hard to do. It is so hard for me to think about where I want to see myself in a year. As far as like location, definitely not here. Like not Texas. I just don't like it. I don't care for it. At first I thought it was the city, but I don't care for Texas as a whole. Nothing against people from here that, has been born and raised here. I just don't care for Texas. I thought that I wanted to go back to New Jersey or New York. As usual, y'all, my camera is running out of storage. Like I was saying before I was so rudely interrupted, I thought I wanted to move back to like Jersey or New York. I'm not really sure. I'm honestly not sure. The only thing I am sure is that I don't want to be in Texas. I tried it. I don't like it. So, back to my assignment. I'm really trying to see where I see myself a year from now, and I never thought that it could be this hard. Not just, like I said, with the location, but as far as career, like just personal stuff. I don't know, y'all. Like, I'm still, and it sounds crazy, I'm actually still trying to find my purpose. Like, I feel like I was, hi. I feel like I'm supposed to be doing something else. Like, I don't feel like I was put here just to be a regular person. Not that there's anything wrong with being regular, but I just feel like I'm supposed to be doing something big or great. I don't know what that something is. I've been trying to figure that something out. A friend of mine, we were talking, and she was like, try to picture your life, like what can you go or what can you not live without? What is the one thing that you feel like you can't live without? You know, besides, you know, my children, you know, family, stuff like that. I don't know. Like, I don't really know. And I feel like I'm not really passionate about anything anymore. And I don't know why that is. So, trying to figure that out, y'all. I'm trying to figure that out. Itchy, y'all. How you doing? I'm trying to figure that out. But anyway, let me get out of here. I done babbled long enough. I just wanted to come up here and yell at y'all for a quick second. Your girl got some work to do. Also, y'all, like, I need some kind of face moisturizer or something like that. What do y'all use to, like, moisturize your face? Like, y'all, I'm about to get out of here. Like I was saying, I tried some Pond's, like, a few weeks ago, and it just messed me all up. So, what do y'all use for, like, face moisturizer and stuff like that? Well, let me go before my phone cuts off again.